Father in heaven, this is going to be part 7. Our Father in heaven, part 7. So we're still going to handle the verse that we have started working on for some time now. Hallowed be your name. Matthew 6 from verse 9. In this manner, therefore, pray, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So this is verse 7. The word hallowed, as explained in the other parts, means to pronounce holy or treat as holy. Hallowed be thy name means let your name be celebrated. Amen?
Amen.
Let your name be esteemed always. Accept proper honor for your name. So let us sum up what we've seen so far from this message. Hallowed be thy name is not only a declaration, it's a request. Not only a declaration, it's a request. We are not saying only that Lord, your name is hallowed. That's not what we are saying only. We are saying, Lord, cause your name to be hallowed in our lives, in every situation of our lives. Cause your name to be hallowed. Cause your name to be believed. Cause your commandments to be obeyed. So when we pray, hallowed be thy name, we mean, Father, let your name be celebrated. Father, let your name be feared. Father, let your name be trusted. Or that you, like it is arranged, trusted be your name. Hallowed be your name. Trusted be your name. And it's let your name be trusted. Honored be your name. Glory be your name. Blessed be your name. So now we can understand that. So, names are so precious. Our names are so important. We all know that. This is going to be the last part to that verse 9. Hallowed be your name. So I want you to be very attentive. I want you to listen to me very carefully. So, names are precious to us. Names are very important. Names reveal who you are. In the Bible times, names reveal someone's character. In the Bible times, a unique part of people to explain or reveal the unique part of people, divine people. And God's names reveal him, represent his attributes. God's names reveal him, represent his attributes, define his ways, and help us to know him. God's names help us to know God. God desires each of us, or each of his names rather, to be hallowed. This is the desire of God, that God be glorified in our lives, that God be trusted. Trusted be your name. He desires that his name should be trusted by everybody. And so God kept his name solid. Isaiah 48 verse 11. For my own sake, I will do it. For how should my name be profaned? And I will not give my glory to another. So God guided his name. God protected his name from everlasting to everlasting. He will be Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So that his name can be trusted. His name can be glorified. Glory be your name. Hallowed be your name. Now, in this part, I want to ask you, what is your name? What is your name? Is the question. You know, people can call you any name they like. They can call you any name. They can say you are not going to be stupid in Jesus' name. They can say that you are stupid, poor, foolish, weak, sick. They can even call you dream killer. But what do you call yourself is very important. So I want you to listen to this message very carefully. What do you call yourself? What name do you give to yourself? Remember, they call Jesus so many names. Sometimes they even said Jesus was using evil power, evil spirit to perform miracles. Say, King of the Jews, when he was dying on the cross, they put a tag there. But Jesus Christ did not limit himself based on the names, or did not accept all those tags. All along, every time Jesus was performing the miracle, it came for everybody. Jesus was demonstrating his power, he was demonstrating his might, he was performing miracles, not based on all those names, bad names that were given to him. The same thing with God. There are people today, some people say there is no God. That doesn't stop God from performing miracles, from showing himself strong in existence, showing himself strong in life. So, not the names people are calling you that is important. It's the name you call yourself. So, what do you call yourself? So as we go deep in this study, I want you to know one thing that is very important. The name you call yourself is what matters. As we are remembering God and we are talking about Him, we remember all the wonderful things God has done, all those things Jesus did in our lives. We can also remember you. You can also shame whatever people are calling you, they are negative, and write your name with gold so that people can remember you for good. Amen? No one can stop God. If people cannot stop God, they cannot stop you. So those names, you have to decide. It is never late. You can still do something about your name. And now, see, one thing that I think is very important that we need to know as we go in and cap these names, we call God the names of God, is this. See, people listen and listen and listen, they never take action. Don't be that kind of a person. Don't just listen and listen without taking actions. There are people in the world today, they just talk, they talk, they talk. Some people, they boast, they are just boasters. They brag and do say many things and no action. Are you just a talker? Are you just a boaster? Are you just a bragger? Or that you take actions, you do something. Whatever people are saying about, whatever people are calling you, do something, take action. Don't just sit down there. Don't just listen to people. Do something. Time is going. Are you an achiever or you are just a boaster? I've seen people, they talk. I've seen people, they just boast. They tell you their intentions. They tell you their plans. And no action. No action. That is not good. I've even seen people, even preachers, they just preach and preach and preach and preach. No action. They lack action. But you have to do something. If you believe in something, take action on that thing. Amen? Amen. Do not procrastinate. Do not say, I will take action tomorrow. I will take action then. Start now. Start to do something. Start on that project. Finish that thing you have started. I have seen people, they will start this one, they will drop it, they will start that one, they will drop it, they never finish anything they have started. So do something about your life, do something. And there are people, they have been studying and they have been listening, they have never come to the point that you will see growth in them. It's not good. See, most time I listen to, as we go, let me say this before I go through those names. Most times I listen to discussions when people discuss about their lives, I listen. Last week there was an interview that Piers Morgan on CNN gave to Montel Williams. I listened to this very carefully. Not that I believe all that they are saying or I follow that they are saying, but you say something that I think is a substance. I try to pick it. Montel said he was diagnosed with multiple cirrhosis, MS, in 1999. And the doctor told him, they gave him a tag. They told him that, listen, in the next 4 years, you're going to be on the wheelchair. That's what they told him. He said, you're going to be on the wheelchair. Because multiple cirrhosis is going to finish all your nerves and all those things, and you're going to be on the wheelchair. And you're not going to be able to eat. And they will tell you, they will say all these things. You will be wearing diapers and this and that. You can't control all those things. Because all those things, controlling those things, will break down. Montel Williams said, he thought about this. I didn't want to take this. He went back He worked on himself, and he said he decided to do three things. Hello? Three things he decided to do. First, try to change his diet. Two, try to exercise every day, he said. And the third thing he did, try as much as possible to take his medications. Change his diet. He was saying that last week that it's now on liquid. Liquid food. Blending fruit with vegetable and things like that. And I said, if I can remember very well, you can quote me if you want, but you don't listen also, but you can go and read the transcript of this this interview with Piers Morgan of CNN. He said that every day he tried to exercise for 1.5 hours. Every day. So he focused on that and he was doing it. You know what they did? You know what the CNN did? Not everybody will do that. They show him, he was shown when he was walking to the podium. And the Piers Morgan asked him, how do you do it? You see walking. Say yes. 1999 I was told, you're going to be on the wheelchair the next 4 years. Now, it's not like I'm praising anybody, but I'm saying this. This world is like a conference. You go to a conference, there will be a tag they will give to you. They will have you to put that tag on somewhere in your body. So they call you because there are so many people in that conference, right? Your name is going to be on that tag, possibly where you came from, on that tag. If you are given a wrong tag, people give people wrong tag. They call you name, they say sick, dream killer, poor. You can change that tag and use God's tag or label. If they give you a wrong tag in a conference, what are you going to tell them? Are you going to be wearing, if you are John Doe and you are giving Philip Nowhere, are you going to be wearing Philip Nowhere around in the conference? You go to the organizer and tell them, this tag you are giving me is not my name, amen? And you tell them to change it, they can put a label on the tag. Stop wearing wrong tags. Change it to God's own tag or label. There's a purpose for everything. Even your parents can give you any name they like. I see parents, they look at some of their children, they look at and say, you, every time I talk to you, I don't think can be anything in life. So parents, they do that. They curse their children, You can change it. Look at, if you open the Bible with me, open to 1 Chronicles chapter 4. I will read from verse 9. Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. His mother had named him Jabez, saying, I gave back to him in pain. Among all his brothers, the mother named him what? Jabez. Means, I gave back to him in pain. And Jabez said, I'm going to shame this tag. I'm going to do what? I'm not going to carry this tag around. And Jabez prayed to God to do that, and he said, maybe you've forgotten, somebody here saying what chapter? 1 Chronicles chapter 4, I'm reading from verse 9. Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. His mother had named him Jabez, saying, I gave back to him in pain. Jabez cried out to the God of Israel, saying, oh, that you will bless me and enlarge my territory. Let your hand be with me and keep me from harm so that I will be free from pain. And God granted his request. God can grant your request today.
Amen.
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 Whatever name anybody is giving you, don't take it. You say you are not going to make it, you are dull, you are poor. Tell them you are not poor because you are serving God, Jehovah Jireh, who can provide. He said, Jehovah Shammah is not going to leave me. He's going to be present in every situation of your life. He will be there with you. Amen? He will be there. He will see you through that journey in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Some of us, we try to run away from challenges. It's either you face it right now or you meet it in the future. I've seen some children, they run away from challenges. It's either when you are with your parents, face these challenges, train yourself to weather any storm so that when you are going to be on your own, you can stand. Amen? You are not going to depend on your parents forever. One day you're going to be on your own. If you fail to face those challenges right now, you're going to face those challenges in the future. This life is a place of challenges. You got to face it one day. Amen.
Amen.
So, look at what Jabez did. He prayed to God. God changed that name. You can do the same thing today. And as we go through the names of God, I want to leave you with this one, very important. Do something on something, amen?
Amen.
Do something. You see, the problem people have in the world today is they keep thinking, how long are you going to think? No action. Do something. God can redeem any situation. He can repair any relationship. He can repair any life. He can mend anything. He can mend any wall. It's God. He can give you strength. He's a present help in trouble. It's God. God can redeem any time. It's never too late with Him. Our Father in heaven. There are parts God will play in your life, and there are parts you have to play yourself. You don't want to leave God to play your part for you. No. No, there are parts, even in salvation, He has played His own part. I had you discussing this morning that Jesus has done it. He has paid for the salvation of our lives. It's not for us to tap that privilege. It's not for us to tap that opportunity. What are you doing? Are you tapping that opportunity? Each of these names that we're going to go through, we can turn each of these names to prayer point. Hello? One time I was thinking, maybe I should just rush this and, we have treated this Hallowed, you know, your name with many parts. Why can't we just go to Thy Kingdom Come and that will be done and just we can rush that? And I was thinking, why should we be rushing? It is good to know this thing thoroughly. It is good to know the Word of God. It is good to be thorough. Well, see, you can turn each of these names to prayer points. Look at the first one. We talked about that last week in the part 6. Jehovah Adonai. The Hebrew word Adonai. You know, when I was in Bible college, I studied Hebrew as a language. I've forgotten so many things I studied about it because I don't speak it every day and I don't read it every day. So in case I'm pronouncing this thing not as the Hebrews will pronounce this, just forgive me. Understand? Jehovah Adonai means the Lord. This is talking about the Lordship of Jesus Christ. You can pray and say, God, be Lord over every situation of my life. He will be Lord. He will take over. Jesus is Lord. We're all saying Jesus is Lord. What we are saying is Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Adonai. He's Lord. Adonai. And we treated this one in extensively last week, so we shouldn't stay on that. I am. The second one was I am. Moses, the children of Israel, tell them, I have sent you. I am who I am. Sent you. He can be I am in every situation of your life. Nobody can take that name. I am. He can be I am in that business. He can be I am in that life. He can be I am in that marriage. He can be I am in that finances. He's I am. Amen?
Amen.
Are you with me this afternoon? I just want you to do something about your life. It's like a conference. Welcome here, one day we are all going to go. For as we go through this conference, somebody gave you a wrong tag. Tell them, take this tag. This is not my name. I'm not John Doe. My name is Emmanuel. You can even shake. I've seen people in the conference. I see people shaking themselves. You gave them wrong tag. They will go and look for a label. They will put it on that tag. Before they leave that place. If the organizer cannot change the tag immediately. If people are giving you wrong tag, change it right now and take God's own label. Amen?
Amen.
You are an achiever.
Amen.
The Lord is great in your life.
Amen.
You are a winner.
Amen.
You are not a loser.
Amen.
You are a victor.
Amen.
You are not going to fail in that business.
Amen.
You are not going to fail in that situation.
Amen.
In that school, you are going to graduate.
Amen.
He's God. You will be successful in that business.
Amen.
In that Christian life, you will make it to heaven.
Amen.
We are not going to backslide.
Amen.
sometimes I kind of, you give some people, even in the church, you give them microphone, they'll be talking negatives. Negatives. Even like in the church. Calling themselves some names that are not their names. You must speak positive all the time. Very good. So look at, there have been so many people that their lives motivate. And that this issue of Montaigne Williams is a good. You as we are all sitting here, we don't know the next phone call. We don't know. You don't know the next doctor's report. You don't know. You don't know. There are some doctor reports, they will list so many things that if you're not careful, you will just drop dead. As soon as we are taking the report after the blood test and everything, you read it like this. They say, A this, A that. Somebody who had this, is that. In the next 1 year, that will happen. And then the leg will be cut, and the hands is gone. This and that, the eyes will not see again. You get all this report if you are not strong. Faith is the victory that overcomes the world. You drop dead. It's not that sickness or that disorder that will kill you. It is the fear attached to the report. That we keep, exactly. We are talking about the names of God to let you know that each of God's names has its actions. These names, they come because of situations that happened. And God will say, and people that have experienced will say, I will call this God Nissi. I mean, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Adonai, Jehovah Shammah, because he was present, it's Jehovah Shammah. Jehovah Rapha, because he will do it, because he will heal me, is the Lord that healeth. I will not die. I have taken it upon myself. I don't live my life based on what people are saying. Honestly speaking, faith will call those things that were not as though they were. Those things that are not as though they were. That is faith. That is faith. If you are talking, talk and motivate. Say things that will encourage people. Amen?
Amen?
And if you don't have anything to say, you shut your mouth. They say the French, we say, Sefini, let it finish. Me shonu, they say in one other language in Nigeria. Me shonu, you close your mouth. Don't say anything. If you don't have anything to say, some people, they run their mouth, they talk negative. When you take somebody's call and he's talking negative, he's telling you how that thing can kill and not kill. Just stop that call. You know that it's not that you are disrespecting that person, but that's not what you want to hear at that time, because it will weigh you down. Something that will not encourage you, don't listen.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Then number three, he said, Ancient of Days, last week, right? Then El Shaddai, Almighty.
It's El Shaddai, it's Almighty. With God, nothing has ever gone out of hand. Nothing has ever gone out of control with God. I was thinking maybe, you know, there was a time I was thinking maybe I should write a book on failure is not final. I've seen some people because they failed, and so what? Because they failed. One man had the best GPA in the University of Lagos. I read it recently, that was the last convocation he had. The best GPA, he read mechanical engineering. And they were interviewing him. He had the best GPA. They were interviewing him. And they asked him, they asked some questions that called. He said, have you ever failed any subject before, or any exam before? He said, yes, he failed before. He said, he failed in mathematics. Somebody who had failed in mathematics before, they have to be able to have the best GPA in mechanical engineering. You don't know mathematics, you can't survive in any engineering profession. You must know mathematics, you must know physics, you must know chemistry. You may not know biology very well. But maths, physics, you must be good to come out in engineering degree. For he told them, he said he failed before in mathematics. Now he had the best GPA in mechanical engineering. Failure is not final. The Almighty God can turn anything around in anyone's life. Anything that God can bring from nothing. He created everything from nothing. Are you telling me that because you failed one time and then that is it? No, that is not it. But it's a determination. It's, you have to decide. You remove the tag of failure, you put the label of victory, the label of success, not ordinary success, good success. Good success. I've had people that had, you know the way they grade, if you are listening to me, you don't know this grade. Somebody who has F9. It means F. I have had people that had F9 parallel. What they talk is that F9. And they came to this country and they studied and they graduated and had the one I can know very well is carrying Harden around now. So are you telling me that it's gone? When there is hope, I mean, when there is life, there is what? There is hope. So you can begin to apply all these names to any situation of your life. Don't let somebody tell you, no, it is too late. God cannot do it. Why are you wasting your time? You think you are the only, your story is the only thing God is thinking about? God is thinking about, did you know how many phone calls going to God at the same time? God knows all of us. I know that the traffic to heaven is busy. That I know. Everybody is praying to God. Even thieves, they are praying. Armed robbers. They pray to God, as we are going to rob people, let us come back safely. Armed robbers. They pray to God. God help me to get somebody to rob today. They pray. So the traffic, phone calls to God. It's so busy. That shouldn't make you not to call your own. Why somebody is also praying, God, don't let Robert get me today. This money I'm taking to God. Don't let me be robbed. And the robber is praying as we are going. Even we have had that some robbers, they tell their wives to keep praying as they go on operation. The wives, they keep praying, they will tell their wives, pray so that I can come back. Pray so that, and the wife will pray, let my husband come back from this operation. And the wife, the husband is going to kill people, he's going to rob people, he's going to destroy, because this will not only come, but this has come to steal and to do what? And to destroy. So the wife will be praying, as my husband is going out to destroy today, let him destroy very well. And the husband is expecting God to answer that prayer. I mean, the wife is expecting God to answer that prayer, right? So don't, because somebody, the traffic is busy, then you are not going to ask God. Nothing is so stupid. Nothing is too small. Nothing is too big to ask God. He is God. He does everything. Amen? And God knows the best thing for you. So we can use some of these names. He's our Father in heaven. Now, we are in a better position. We are in a better stand because we are his children. So we can call him our Father because he's here for us. Amen? Amen. And Jesus is teaching us this so that we can have confidence to call God Father, Abba Father. And Jesus is teaching us this. Any situation, call on his name. The next one I want us to treat this morning is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord our healer. Who is our healer? Exodus 15:26. And said, if you diligently heed the voice of the Lord your God, and do what is right in his sight, give ear to his commandments, and keep all his statutes, I will put none of these diseases on you, which I have brought on the Egyptians, for I am the Lord who heals you. Who heals?
Lord.
He is the Lord. Jehovah Rapha is the Lord that heals. The Lord, our healer. God heals. Just because of what they have told you or what you have heard about that disease, some of us, you know, because we're in a technological age now, some of us, as soon as the doctor says, this is what is happening to you, they will go to the internet, they will put that, the name of that disease, they will read all those things, how that disease has finished people, how that disease has, you know, destroyed people's lives, they will read and then they will be panicking. I'm not saying it's wrong to do that, to go and research into whatever is happening, but it is wrong to take the negative aspect and apply it to your own situation. You are unique.
Amen.
Your DNA is special.
Amen.
And right in your DNA, there is hidden power of God in that DNA, because Jehovah Rapha is
He's saying that I am in your DNA.
Amen.
I am the Lord that heals you. He is our healer. He can heal that disease. God is the healer. He will heal that marriage. He will heal that family. He will heal that business. He will heal that finances. He will heal that situation. If any of your children is giving you challenge, call Jehovah Rapha. He will repair. He will redeem. He will repair every broken thing. Jehovah Shalom, the Lord who is present. The Lord is present in every situation of our lives. If not for God, what are you going to be saying? If God is not present in your house while you are sleeping, what are you going to be saying? If God is not present in that trip, that journey, what are you going to be saying? If God is not present in the church, what are we going to be saying? If God is not present in that finances, what are you going to be saying? If God is not present in that business, what are you going to be saying? We need to pray. We need to pray so that God can be present even in our office. I was talking to somebody, you know, over the week. They said the governor, the yesterday governor of Illinois, will address the public when the day before he goes to game. That is Rod. And I was talking to somebody. I'm not against government. And I'm not against the law. But you know, sometimes life is not fair.
Yeah.
You know that?
Yeah,
sometimes life is not fair. That's why you need to pray. I swear, Jehovah Shammah will always be with you wherever you go.
Amen.
And this person, we are talking together, I said, why is this man going to jail for 14 years? Tell me one thing he did. Tell me one thing that we can say. Tell me how many people he killed. He's going to jail for 14 years because of intent to do it. Talking, I am going to do it. But no action yet. Thinking out. And he's going to jail 14 years. The man is about 50 something years old. By the time you have 15 years, you'll be clocking almost 70 by the time he comes back. And Bible says after 70 is by the grace of God. Amen?
Amen.
3 score and what?
Ten.
And 10. Sometimes life is not fair, right? Some of us say, I'm very smart. I do everything to the day. I am this. Yes, you are smart. I'm not saying you are not smart, but you need to pray. So God can help you. You need to pray on that finances. You need to pray on that in your life. You need to pray on that in your education. I have seen a situation whereby just one lecturer can change the destiny of your education. Just one lecturer. Just one lecturer. Just look at you like this. There is nothing you say that is right. There is nothing you write that is correct. One lecturer can run you out of a college. You need to pray. So that maybe by the time you do that subject, that lecturer will be sick.
Amen.
Another lecturer. It has happened. That lecturer will be sick, they will bring another lecturer to work for that semester, and by the time he comes back, you have...
Hallelujah!
I am telling you, we need to pray for any situation. You are going out to a discussion on a business meeting, you need to pray. So that one bad person will not be in that committee. Who always opposes what we are saying? I say, don't give this business to this person. Who always opposes you? You can pray it. If by the time you plan to come, the inspector will break down. His phone is not going to work. Or he will call it sick. See, God moves in such a way that sometimes some things will happen to us, we don't know why it happens. It is after you are reading your memoir, if you have written anything, you begin to say, oh God, this is why you did this. God, so this is where we are going. God is not going to give you the whole, you know, blueprint of your life, the whole map. He's not going to give it to you. It's one day at a time. And when you depend on him, when you have him as your father in heaven,
Then you have what? Rest of mind. You have peace. You have peace.
Jehovah Shammah, the Lord who is present.
Ezekiel 48 verse 35. Ezekiel 48 verse 35. All the way around shall be 18,000 cubits. And the name of the city from that day shall be, the Lord is there. Who is there?
Lord.
The Lord is there. Through your walk, through the shadow of this valley of the dead, you will fear no evil because the Lord is where? Even when you are in the valley of shadow of death, you will fear no evil because Jehovah Shammah is there. Is the Lord who is there, who is present. God will be there because his name is Jehovah Shammah. The power of life may be heated 7 times, though it could be heated so much. The mechanism of your life may want to kill you. It's not going to succeed.
Amen.
Because Jehovah Shammah is there. The Lord will walk with you.
Amen.
In that strip. In the midst of that fire, you will not be burned. Isaiah 14 verse 11. For my own sake, I will do it. For how should my name be profaned? He will not let you disgrace his name. His name will be trusted in your life. He will be there. He will make himself holy on your behalf. In the battle of life, you will not do it alone. Jehovah Shammah will walk with you and you will overcome in that battle. Because the battle is not your battle. If you have a father in heaven, is that battle your battle? No, it's not your battle. He will fight that battle for you.
Amen.
If your husband is at home, hello, your husband is at home, do you have to do it alone? Your husband is at home, you want to pick something that is higher, you want to climb on the table to pick something, on the chair to pick something. Your husband is at home and you are sitting near each other. What are you going to say?
Honey,
can you help me pick that? Honey will gladly climb and pick it for you. Amen?
He
will gladly. So, why are you carrying that load yourself? I have given you this story before. Somebody was giving a ride. He was standing on the side of the road with his load on his forehead, and a vehicle stopped and asked him or her to enter the vehicle. And he entered the vehicle because he needed more space. The driver allowed him to sit, or the owner of the car allowed him to sit. Let me use him. Allowed him to sit at the back of the car. And once the trip was on, and then the driver or the owner just looked at the rear mirror and saw this person sitting carrying the load on his head while sitting on the car. And the driver, the owner said, why are you still carrying your load on your head? Put it on the floor. Oh, he said, oh, thank you, sir. Put it on the floor. I said, I thought you just gave me a ride, not my load. That's why I'm carrying it. No. God has provision for everything that you have.
Absolutely.
Every situation of your life.
Amen.
It's called, all you that are every lady, all you that are laboring every day, because he has that place of rest for us. He will take care of everything. He will mend every wall. He will repair every life. It's not only you. He is able to heal every other situation around you. He is God. I want to thank God for your life. I just want you to place action in this message. Amen.
Amen.
Just do something. Every part in this message is unique. And I know this part 7 is unique. You can apply the names of God into any situation of your life.
Amen.
When the enemy is making noise, shouting like a roaring lion, tell enemy, listen, Jehovah Shammah is with me here. I'm not alone here. You are just making noise. If you are not careful, you lion, the Jehovah Shammah that's in my life will remove all the teeth in your mouth. And you will be greater than useless. You can talk to the enemy. You can talk to the situation. You can tell that mountain to be moved. It will be moved. Jehovah Rohi, the Lord my shepherd. And you know, we had this one especially when we are treating Psalm 23. Psalm 23 verse 1 says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. When they call you poor, tell them I'm not poor because I have a shepherd who is the Lord. I shall not want any good things. When they say you are poor, Tell them you are not poor. You are rich.
Amen.
Let the poor say, I am what?
Amen.
I am rich. Because Philippians 4:19 says, our Lord shall supply to all our needs according to his riches in glory through Christ Jesus our Lord. He will supply. Hello? He will supply to every need of your life.
Because he's Jehovah Rohi, the Lord, my shepherd. Elohim, God's power and might. Psalm 19 verse 1. The heaven declare the glory of God, and the promise show his handiwork. Elohim, God's power and might. He's a powerful God. He created everything. He created all that we are looking at. So he's so powerful. So what is in your life that God cannot create? What is in your life that cannot create? Let's trust God, brethren. Let's trust him. Hello. Let's trust him. He will see you through that journey.
Amen.
I don't know what you are passing through right now. I don't know what you are facing right now. But he is able to see you through. He is able to see you through. It's Jehovah Elohim. God's power and might. He got all power. All power in heaven and on earth has been given to Jesus Christ. And that is why at the name of Jesus, every knee must bow. Every knee must bow. And every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. All to the glory of God the Father, our Father in heaven. Every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. That situation in your life must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Are you with me this afternoon?
Yes, sir.
I'm trying to put fire into our bosom. I want you to arise and shine.
Amen.
I want you to do something. Don't just be people that just talk. People talk. Some people, they talk, they boast around, they brag, you know, and no action. It's not good. Do something. If you have a plan to do something, work on that intention. Amen?
Amen.
Be an achiever. Achieve something. Don't just sit down there. Do something about your life. Let's apply the word of God to our lives, to the situation of our lives. Pray about all these things. Another thing is that God that we are serving is a merciful God. He's a what? A merciful God. That's one of the names of God. Merciful God. Jeremiah 3:12. Go and proclaim these words toward the north and say, return backsliding Israel, says the Lord, I will not cause my anger to fall on you. For I am merciful, says the Lord, I will not remain angry forever. He is a merciful God. He's a merciful God. One other version calls that place exactly, I am merciful God. He's a merciful God. He will have mercy on you. Some of us, we have beaten ourselves out because of our past. Even if we have done some terrible things in the past. He's a merciful God. God is not looking at that past. Amen?
Amen.
He has forgiven you. When people are accusing you, that one has done this. God will say, what are you talking about? The blood of my son, Jesus Christ, has wiped that away. That is gone. Don't remember that. He's a new person. He's a brand new person now. He's a merciful God. He said, I will have mercy unto whosoever I will have mercy unto, and I will have compassion unto whosoever I will have compassion unto. We are all asking for his mercy. We are all asking for his compassion. And God will be merciful unto you. You will be counted as those that God will be merciful unto. He's a merciful God. Look at Lamentations. Lamentations, I love this place very well. I love this place. Oh my God. Lamentations chapter 3, verse 21 to 24. Say, this I recall to my mind. Therefore, I have hope. Through the Lord's mercies, we are not consumed. Because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I hope in him. Where do you put your hope? Is in the Lord. He's a merciful God. Psalm 86 verse 15. But you, O Lord, are a God full of compassion and gracious, long-suffering, abundant in mercy. He's a merciful God. He can turn anything around. Look, God can turn anything around. I was listening, you know, those of you that were here, I think it was in 2005 when Ebenezer Obey came to the church here. He was giving the story of his life. There's something he said that really touched me. His mother was married to a man.
And his mother had no child, no single child. And after a while, this man just left the man, left the woman, left his mother. And another man will marry the woman back. That's Obed's mother. And it was that man that his mother now had children too. And one of those children had thought to be a son. You see what God can do? You see what God can do? Sometimes we look, you know, because we have this naked eye, can see Father. You say, this world is useless. If somebody is thinking you are useless and they abandon you, God will not abandon you. Yeah. God can turn this around in your life and make it useful. And your name will be written with gold. He can do it. He's a redeemer. He's our redeemer. He can do it. And see, that is why you must not. You look, I tell you something. You don't have final say about anybody. It's God that has final say. It's God that has final say about somebody. You don't have final say about somebody. It's God that can say, this is it. And it will be it. When you are still thinking, this is it, God can say, no, this way I'm going. Because my ways are not your ways. Neither my thoughts are your thoughts. As heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways. Amen?
Amen.
It's all you that will decide. It doesn't matter what names they are calling you. We are talking about God today because no matter what names they are calling God, God remains God. Amen?
Yeah.
Even for those that say there is no God, God remains God. Even not now, forever. Be stable. People can say anything about you, you stand out. Amen?
Amen.
Stand out. Then look, conclude that you will make it. You will do it. If all of us are looking for, do you know that this one other thing I have seen about life? If you are looking at all your reports when you are in the college, you'll be changing program to program. You'll be running away. A friend of mine was talking to me about his son. His son went to college to do medicine. That was the plan of this son. What did he end up to have? English. English. True life story. And this is somebody I know very well. He went to college for medicine. He went to one of the best schools, Urbana-Champaign, University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign. He was changing. You know this country, as soon as we're over 18, they will play, you cannot go call for your record. They will not tell. So the boy, the father will just tell him, the father, you know, it's only when you are told, at home you can say, hey, you. I say, go and do medicine. His medicine was too. Are you listening to me? Go and tell your mother that I said it's messy you are going to do. Some of us, we could go to our mother and say, mommy, go tell daddy that it should please, I want to be an engineer, it should please. And you know our mother, they know how to press the button.
Yeah.
Maybe early in the morning or in the night. Maybe after action. Hello? Maybe after action. Or maybe when the action is about to happen. Mommy can just go on that list. Only before we go for that. Hello? I'm hoping you know how to press button. Before we go, before you go for that, you see, Anani just told me, Anani just told me that, he want to do engineering. And then before the woman will say, begin to, call the names of, you are the son of this one. Your father is like this. Before I marry you, I know you are the best. You are the most handsome man. I know about your father. In your house, you are victors. In your house, you are never. But some men will still say, with all that you have said, I want him to do mercy. But this country we are, if your son should tell you I'm not doing mercy, what are you going to do? In fact, he will just go to school. He can even go to school and tell them, I have no father, I have no mother. I have no father, I have no mother. He can even say they are dead. You don't see that he's in the school. He's going to school. So this boy was changing. Maybe we just, there's no time you cannot have roadblock. But for somebody who knows the name of God, when people are saying roadblock, you will see highway.
Yeah.
Are you listening to me? For somebody who
one challenge, some children, as soon as they have seen that challenge, they will change the course. They will say, they will think it's easier, it's better there. They think it's better at the other side. That's why some people, they backslide. They will always think it's greener at the other side. Until they jump on the other side, they will say, you see, this one is even not as good as the one I was, and then to go back, let me continue. And again, they see also, let me go to the other side. And before they know it, this boy ends up graduating English major from science, from being a medical doctor. It's a merciful God. We see you through. Focus on that journey. Forward, ever, backward, never turn back at the point or edge of victory. Faith is the victory that overcomes the world. Amen?
Amen.
You will not drop on the roadside by the grace of God.
Amen.
You will arrive at your destination.
Amen.
Because the thought that passed for you is a thought of peace and not of evil to give you a hope. To give you a word, a future. I'm not talking about anybody here. Some of you may be thinking that, Pastor is talking about me. Maybe my dad told Pastor about my story. I don't know which story you are talking about, but I'm telling you about life. This is what people commonly do. This is what people commonly do. People do the same thing in business. When we are back home, there's some women. I grew up in face-to-face house. Hello?
Hi.
I grew up in... I'm a Lagos boy. I was a Lagos boy, rather. No. Lagos boy. I grew up in Shomolu, the heart of Lagos. This is a place they don't close the door in the night. Everywhere is busy. It's busy throughout the night. There's some women. Today they will sell buns. Tomorrow you see them, they are selling their Obi. Akamu. Tomorrow they see that they will change. They are selling a... They shake and shake and shake and shake. They never focus. Because each business has its own challenges. There is nothing in this life that has no bend on the road. There is no dwelling that is not having a bend or potholes. But it has to do with how you attend to situations as you meet those challenges on your life journey. And we begin to apply this name of God. It's God. This name can work. It works for some people. If it works for some people, it will work for you.
Amen. Because
God is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Amen.
I know. Even some pastors, they do the same thing. They open church today, they close church. Some people, they think when they open church, some they think they can't success based on how many billions they have. That's not success. They open church today, as soon as they see challenges like this, they close shop. The challenges may even be elders of the church. Some people just came recently to us, to my wife and I, and they just told us that the church they started, we were in that church, we attended service in that church at Indiana. They came and told us it's what? Close down. They face small challenges, they will close down. Some they want money. Some they open church for money. And not this day. This day should be disappointed. You know, people, we know where they put their money these days. People don't put their money here. They don't put their money where you can easily steal their money. You can only steal money of some slow people. People that are slow these days. I was telling story about Lagos. They don't want people to carry money around now in Lagos. You go with your card. You go with card. Any armed robber pickpocket that will steal your card, before you go and use it in the bank, you call the bank, they cancel it. So those of you that think that you go and do church service or you go and open church because you want money, you are going to be disappointed. You will close churches easily. Hello?
Hi.
Or you want ministry so that some are so lazy. I've seen some people, they are lazy. They can't even walk. Don't let me shift topic. Let's quickly go through this. Jealous. Jealous. What is God's name?
Jealous. This one, this name of God is one. Most of us will disable God in this one.
I think women mostly.
Women mostly.
Some women that are jealous. You are a woman who walk too close to their husband. Ah, you see their red eyes, red one, because they disable God. I don't blame you, money. I don't do what. And I think some men also are jealous. Honestly. Look at Exodus 34 verse 14. For you shall worship no other God, for the Lord whose name is jealous is a jealous God. That is why God cannot, you cannot compete with God at all. You can't take God's glory. God is jealous.
And I think I'm like God, I'm jealous too.
Are you jealous? There is no sin to be jealous. Because it's in the name of God.
I'm just joking.
So God is so jealous. He wants you. He wants the whole of you. Don't take his place. Amen?
Amen.
Jehovah Tisikenu. Me, the Lord, our righteousness. Jehovah Tisikenu. Jeremiah 23, verse 6. In his days, Judah will be saved, and Israel will dwell safely. Now, this is his name, by which he will be called, the Lord, our righteousness. It's our righteousness. When enemy begin to, you know, condemn you, and say, you are this, you are that, you are a sinner, you are useless, you can't get to heaven, tell the enemy that it's our righteousness. That our getting to heaven will be by the righteousness of Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Because we are serving Jehovah to the kennel. Our righteousness. It's our righteousness. It's our hope.
Jehovah Jireh. This one is so common, right?
Yes.
Genesis 22, verse 20, 13 to 14. Mean that God will provide.
Then Abraham lifted his eyes and looked, and there behind him was a ram caught in thicket by his horns. So Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up for a burnt offering instead of his son. And Abraham called the name of the place, the Lord will provide, as it is said this day, in the month of the Lord it shall be provided. He will provide. If Jehovah Jireh, if they say you are poor, tell them I'm rich. Because Jehovah Jireh will provide. He will provide. He is the Lord. He will supply to every need of our lives. Jehovah Nissi, the Lord is my banner. Who is your banner? His banner over us is all. It's the banner of our lives. Exodus 17, verse 15. And Moses built an altar and called his name, the Lord is my banner. This happened at the battle of Rabidim. He is the Lord. He will provide. He's the banner of our lives. He's the banner over us. Jehovah Nissi. So you can pray this prayer. You know that Exodus 17. Remember the story that happened there? When they were fighting, I think the Amalekite or so, they were fighting, and then, you know, Moses was helped by Aaron and Hor, I think Hor was another person helped, to lift up his hand. As he lifted up his hand, Israel was prevailing. But when the hands of Moses is so tired and he wanted to drop it, they will help him to lift it up. These two men will lift up his hand for him. And eventually they won the battle. I don't know the story very well. I mean, I don't have it offhand very well, but Moses eventually called the place Jehovah Nissi. And that's where I'm going. The Lord is my banner. Because they won eventually, and God was the banner over him on that battle. We'll be banner over you on your battle of life, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And then look at Gideon's situation too. So what I'm trying to say is that they called God these names based on the situation happening to them, and the victory they received from this situation, and they named God after that victory. So, we can apply the same thing to our situation and we will have it accordingly. Amen?
Amen.
Jehovah Shalom. Who said this? Gideon. Judges 6, verse 24. So, Gideon built an altar there to the Lord and called it the Lord is peace. To this day, it is still in Ophrah of the Abyssinites. The experience Gideon had with God caused him to name that place Jehovah Shalom, the Lord is peace. He will grant you peace. Peace that money cannot grant,
peace that pleasure cannot grant, peace that the world cannot give you, peace that the your friends cannot give you, peace that the prince cannot give you, God will give you that peace because he is the Prince of Peace. Gideon called the place what?
Jehovah Shalom.
Peace. So he said, when you tell somebody Shalom, you are talking Hebrew. What are you talking?
Peace.
Hebrew. Peace. Shalom. Peace. So when they finish delighting their letter, they put Shalom. Peace. It's our peace.
The Lord is so big, so great, so strong and mighty, there's nothing God cannot do. I want us to sing that song. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
I think we have it on the screen, right?
My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the rivers are his, the stars are his, and the world too. Amen. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do for you, for me, for us.
For snow candy.
I'm not giving you candy.
If I told you the Sunday school, they, you know, it's like promising you, sing God, we will give you candy at the end. We give you biscuit. And most of that, then we eat one biscuit they call Oki. Remember that biscuit?
Amen. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the rivers are his, the stars are his, and the world too. Amen. My God is so great, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do for you, for me, for us, for it.
Father, we thank you, bless you this afternoon, and worship you because of your names. Your names are great. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised.
You have so many names that we can call you. And your names are filled with actions.
Jehovah Roi, the Lord, our shepherd.
And you have been our shepherd from the beginning, from ages past.
Jehovah Shalom, the Lord is present.
And you have been present in every situation of our lives. And you are still present right now, Jehovah Rapha. You are the Lord, our healer. You have healed so many diseases, and you are still healing now.
If you are going to count all the healing Jesus gave, all the diseases Jesus healed, the book you are going to write, may fill the whole of this world. You are our healer. We bless your name, we worship you.
Jehovah Adonai, you are the Lord of everything, every situation of our lives.
As we call you these names, and as we shall continue to use these names, as these names worked for the people of old, it shall work for us in the mighty name of Jesus.
You are I am that I am. You are I am of any situation in our lives. You are I am.
Father, as we continue to call you the Ancient of Days, the Almighty God, El Shaddai, so continue to call your name, O God. We pray, Lord, that it shall continue to work for us as for the people of God, the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are Elohim, God's power and might.
Amen.
Father, be power and might in our lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are merciful, God. Be merciful unto us, O God.
Amen.
According to your steadfast love, Father, be merciful.
Amen.
You are a generous God. Help us, O God, to recognize you and to give you your place in our lives. So that we shall not share your glory with you because you are a jealous God. You are Jehovah Jireh. Father, help us, O Father, and provide. Continue to provide according to your riches in glory. Provide to all the needs of our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Jehovah Tesikelu, you are our righteousness. Where enemies will be telling us that we are sinners, we are nothing, we cannot make it to heaven. Help us to tell the enemy that you are our righteousness.
Amen.
That our going to heaven is not based on our righteousness, because all our righteousness are like filthy rags. But our going to heaven shall be based on the death of Jesus on the front of the cross of Calvary and the promises he has given, that anyone that shall call on the name of the Lord, the same shall be saved. We shall be saved in the mighty name of Jesus.